pictures. First, it says it refers to emotional management skills which provide competency to balance emotions and reasons so as to maximize long-term happiness. We will not go into that definition part of it. Let us start off with the picture representation itself. This picture shows the personality, that is we as an individual, which says it is a combination of IQ and EQ. IQ, we are all aware of what IQ is. It is basically the intelligent quotient. That is, that basically comes from the knowledge we have gained so far. That is basically from the academic background, the educational qualifications we've had, with the experiences we've had so far in our career. All these contributes to our intelligent quotient, that is IQ level. We feel if somebody's IQ level is very high, they are very successful people in life. But actually it is not the case. IQ is important, but to a certain level. Without the presence of the EQ level, that is emotional quotient or emotional intelligence, it is difficult for us to get to the level we want to reach. In the next slide, we will see how. Nikunj, can you just stay? See, this picture itself is very clear. What it shows is IQ gets you hired. That means when you go for an interview, wherever you are going, when you have a basic conversation with your interviewer, he will check your IQ level. Because at the very first level, EQ assessment is not very easy. I mean, at the say immediately in 10-15 minutes conversation, you cannot judge anybody on their EQ level. That comes into picture only when you start working with people, right? So IQ will help you to get higher. If your intelligent quotient is higher, if you have a very good knowledge base, you have a very good industry knowledge, knowledge related to your job, that will help you get placement in the organization. Thereafter, your EQ will decide whether you continue to work, whether you are promoted or you are fired. Why? Because it is basically how you deal with people, how you handle people. Whether it is your peer group, your subordinates, your superiors. So how you handle people is equally important, in fact more important than your what knowledge you are carrying. Because if you're working in a team, everywhere this will be applicable. If you are working in a team, there's a team leader. If that team leader is very knowledgeable person, but unless and until that person is able to share his knowledge with their team members, that will be of not value, because the team members are looking towards the team leader to learn something new. So even the organization would also expect the team leader to pass on the knowledge that they have in a manner, in a fashion that they are able to learn and give productive output, right? So EQ level is something which will help you tie up and connect with people around you. Even with your superiors, if you're talking to your superiors, if you're handling your superiors, you are in connection with them, there is a way in which you handle people. Because you'll have to understand certain things. That is, every individual is a different person. And you cannot, there is a saying, you cannot use the same stick for everybody, because it is, you cannot use the same way in which you handle all the people, right? Because all the five fingers are not the same. If I'm talking to her, she may be a different person, she may react to the situation in a different way. The same thing if I'm talking to somebody else, I'm telling or I'm explaining to somebody else, that person may not have that ability to grasp the way she did it. So I have to first understand what are the capabilities of my team members And what are the different ways and means which I can use to train my team members in a way that they all perform at the same level without applying the same methods of explanation, right? This is IQ is related to our brain.